Hey guys, I'm PetiteGreek, and today we're going to learn about an attorney who became a fashionpreneur on their story told. I'm here with Leah Frazier, and we're here at this oh-so-cool Neil Bantu studio in Dallas, Texas. Leah, thank you so much for talking to me today.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. This is so much fun, and I'm just going to go through your list of your resume because it's incredible.
So take a deep breath.
Yes. Everyone has time because it's a long list and impressive. Founder and editor-in-chief of Inspire and Style magazine. Founder and owner of Fashionpreneur Institute. Owner of Diamond Icon Image and Consulting. Styling consultant. She's a fashion journalist, editor. Speaking is her passion. She has been featured on Vogue.com, CBS Local, Chase TV, Fox TV, Good Morning Texas, and her legal contributions have been on Oxford Press and DFW Style Daily. So, Leah, how does all of this evolve?
I really thought that I was going to be a judge, so that's where the legal contribution came in, because I wrote a chapter out of one of my judges' books that I was an extern for, so that was the path that I was going on until I had a dream in my first job out of law school, and it was about styling women, and I'm like, okay, this is weird. So I just kept going back to sleep, but I kept having the same dream, and so I decided, let me look into this. How do I become a personal shopper? How do I get into style? Because I always like to dress up in the office mm-hmm. in a corporate setting, but always make it different. And the women in the office would always be like, where did you get that? Or where did you get this? I'm like, I'm not telling you all my secrets.
That's right.
Like, maybe just a little bit, but not all my secrets.
Absolutely.
And so I took a certification course and learned how to build the business and started with the first woman was actually an associate out of my law office.
Wow.
Started with her closet and then her husband and then her friend at a big law firm. And it just kind of evolved from there. And eventually, things just kind of blew up, and I had to choose law or fashion,
wow.
and I chose my passion, which is fashion, and so that's where I'm
That's
at
phenomenal.
Today.
That's amazing. Oh my God, that's so exciting too. And so you founded and you're editor-in-chief of Inspire and Style magazine.
Yeah.
When you started that, I guess what inspires you, or I guess what inspired you, and then what has developed so far that has been surprising to you out of that whole magazine and developing the whole idea?
Well, originally, when I started my styling company, I didn't know what I was doing. Obviously, I was trained legally. So I decided I'm going to start blogging. So this was about 7 years ago before everybody kind of started blogging. And I figured this is a way for me to showcase my expertise, even though I had no idea what I was doying.
Mm-hmm.
So I was going to Neiman Marcus's events and events around town and then putting them on examiner.com, which turned into CBS Local,
wow.
which turned into my personal blog. So I was writing for 5 different outlets. And then DFW Style Daily came along when I moved back to Dallas, and I just decided, you know what? I love fashion, but a lot of it is so surface level. My most
yeah.
pieces that really got me going were the stories of people and how they got from A to Z. So it was a hard decision to make, but I went ahead and left and decided to do Inspire and Style because I wanted to inspire people and just have a positive, you know, website out there where people can go to and say, that inspired me to do this, or that mm-hmm. was an excellent story, Leah. Like, it made me want to do X, Y, and Z.
That's
so
great.
Whether I got one click or 20,000,
sure.
I was writing about the things that I felt were important and what needed to be out in the virtual space.
Right. That's fantastic.
And the one thing that was surprising, great. I think, is I just thought it was going to be a Dallas thing.
Yeah.
And I felt like it was going to take me time to build it up again to the level of where DFW Style Daily and all those other mm-hmm. magazines were. And really, I was getting hits out of Austin and Vegas
wow.
and New York
Fantastic.
Out the gate. And I'm like, I don't have any true readers yet because this is a new website.
Sure.
And I don't know how they got my information because it was the Inspire and Style email address. It wasn't
oh, wow.
the prior one. So I don't
yeah.
know what they were on, but they
found you somehow.
So that was the most surprising thing, is that, you know, people from all over were trying to have things published on the site and not just Dallas.
Sure, that's fantastic. That's kind of where you want it to go anyway, right?
Yeah.
To spread the word throughout, besides Dallas. What's one job in your past that you've had that has helped you to where you are today?
Obviously the attorney.
Yeah.
The legal background. I would say the most important, I guess the characteristic in it, is the negotiations.
Oh,
so
sure.
I negotiate my own contracts.
Perfect.
If anybody wants to do any kind of deals, mm-hmm. I can read contracts. I know what's supposed to be in there. I know what's legal, what's not legal. And I know how to barter, because I've had to do 6-8 hour mediations. So it's definitely helped out.
That's fantastic. That is
no one's going to pull the wool over
That's
my
right.
eyes.
That's a great thing to have in your back pocket. I wish I had that. That's
exactly.
fantastic. Yes. So who inspires you most?
My mom. She was, I grew up in a single parent household. And so a lot of my independent woman, mm-hmm. like, strength characteristics came from my mom, because I had to watch her, you know, with three kids, just kind of survive. And
sure.
so a lot of that, my strong-willed and my persistence and things like that, definitely came from her. And her closet is phenomenal.
Really?
Yeah, we were talking about Halston before we started recording. My mommy had Halston perfume.
Oh, I remember. My mother had that too.
You know?
Yes.
And it was in, I remember the bottle. It was like this oval teardropped bottle. Mm-hmm. And so my mom is a fashionista.
I
would go in her closet. Everything's organized in her closet. The shoes are all in their little boxes. And
That's
I'm
great.
Like, I organize closets, but who really has time for that?
That's true.
She does.
She does.
Is that for my own? I got to get better.
Yeah, I know. I hear you.
But yeah,
that's
so
great.
It's my mommy.
So she inspired you fashion as well as just, I mean, your work ethic, your your independence. I mean, that's awesome. That's so awesome. I love that. So what gets you out of bed in the morning? What gets you fired up?
When I think about fashion.
Yeah.
So I love inspiring people through clothes and mm-hmm. style and beauty, and to wake up every day and to be able to say, I mean, if I had it my way, I would love to just write on fashion every single day. Like, that is what calms me. It's very weird.
That is interesting. I love that, though.
It's like, what do you do to calm? Oh, I'll either have my Vogue or W Magazine, or I just discovered a great one downtown, 1530 Main.
Oh.
It's a publication they had at Traffic.
Okay.
And I pulled it and I read it this past Sunday and I was like, this is fantastic.
That's great.
But that's what gets me going, because after I read that, I was like, okay, I'm ready to write.
I love that.
I'm ready to go create.
Mm-hmm.
And it just keeps those juices flowing that makes me realize, like, this is what I'm supposed to be doing.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. That's awesome. So, and how does, speaking of fashion, how does one keep up with the ever-changing styles throughout the season for men and women? I mean, like, you found this really great thing that was great in the summer, and now it's out, you know, or it's fall or winter. It's tough to keep it going.
It's so hard, and I even have a hard time keeping up. It's really like, if you're just kind of the ordinary Joe Schmo, I would just say find those bloggers that you really, or those publications that you really, really like. They're going to be on trend. They're always going to be in the new, whatever's out. Mm. Personally, for myself, I do read all the fashion magazines. I read all the editorials. When Fashion Week's going, if I'm not there, I'm live streaming, or I'm catching, you know, the Cliff Notes version.
Yeah.
The recap through either Elle or Glamour or Vogue themselves. So it's hard, but I think if you're a professional in the industry, you have to do it.
Yes.
And FGI is important to me. So that's Fashion Group International. I'm a member, and they do a trends recap. Comes from Mary Lou Luther, who's like a goddess in the industry, and she tells us everything we need to know. And I think it's like an hour-long video.
Oh, great.
And I'm set.
Wow. Yeah, so you're like, you know what's on trend
set.
For the season.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's wonderful. Good to know that.
So
because your career is so multifaceted, you know, from an attorney to an editor.
And she's crazy.
She's a stylist. How do you keep that balance of life and work and your passions alive and yet, you know, your work and have fun in life? Is it possible?
It's
I don't
possible.
Know how it's
you know, I'm not going to lie. I'm going to be very honest. It's very hard to do, but I think that if you are doing what you love, it doesn't really seem like things are out of balance.
True.
I think if I just do too much of what I love, then I know that I'm neglecting something kind of on the back end. So
you're having too much fun.
I'm having too much fun. Let me go That's be right. with, you know, my dog. Yeah. I don't know. But I think for me, the most important thing, and this is, I've only implemented this recently because I realized I was getting a little bit, you know, too consumed in what I was doing, is just really creating boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, I may put up an out of office on Saturday and Sundays. Personally, I may be working on Saturday, but on Sunday, it's like, girl, you're unavailable.
Yeah.
And I just last week said, I'm not going to work on Sundays.
Good.
Well, this Sunday, I kind of scheduled a little bit, but I kind of had to. But
sometimes you have to, yeah, as an
implement,
entrepreneur.
Yeah. Implement a no Sunday policy. Mm-hmm. And what I did all day, I locked, threw my phone on the bed, no social media, no TV,
That's
no
great.
Nothing. I sat on my couch, I read and I wrote all day, and it was... So creating those boundaries where I can balance.
Yeah.
That's and unplug.
Great idea. The boundaries are so important. Yes. You have to do that in a whole different aspect from your work to your life. And
right.
I mean, even people in your life.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes. So that's great. So give me three words that describe you and your journey to where you are today.
Okay. It was definitely challenging.
I get that.
Up and down, up and down, up and down.
I get
down.
That.
Down, 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 down. Up, down.
Yes.
So very challenging. Yeah. Definitely just a risk taker.
Yeah.
And awesome. So I know it sounds a little crazy. I'm like, okay, what's the best word? I always say awesome, awesome.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
That's
so
great.
I had a penny to my name and I was still out there grinding and doing this.
Mm-hmm.
I may be a little stressed. But it's been awesome, and I never regret my decision.
That's
I may
great.
Question it, but I haven't regretted it.
Regret, as Gary Vaynerchuk says, regret is poison. So
yes.
Yeah, no, it's true. Good for
yes.
you. That's great. So what would you tell yourself 10 years? What advice would you give yourself 10 years ago?
Just go for it, girl. Who cares?
Yeah.
I was so concerned with, is so-and-so going to be mad at me, or is so-and-so going to think a certain thing about me if I'm too confident in what I'm doing? And I was a people pleaser, and to a certain extent I am still today, because I don't cut my clients off when I should. You know, I let them text me late at night.
Mm-hmm.
And God forbid I get married one day and the boo is like, no honey.
Yeah.
Like, what
right.
So I, you know, I've got to get better about that. But tell me a question again.
Now I completely just forgot.
See, I got too much going on in my brain.
No,
right,
that's
now.
Okay.
Like, oh,
what
clients.
Advice?
I kept saying clients.
What advice would you give yourself?
Oh, yeah, that. So, not to really care about what other people think about you,
yeah,
and
good.
To just go for it.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of, I've gotten this fearless mentality, I would say, over the last year.
That's great.
Where I feel like I'm put here on this earth for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
I'm operating in my space, and now I've got to do those things to keep that momentum going. So if I have an idea, I'm acting out on it, and I'm just throwing stuff at the wall like, will this stick? And having that kind of mentality, you are the answer to what somebody's out there searching for.
That's true.
And they don't know they need you.
Good point. Yeah.
But there could be somebody else out there that's not as good, but they're, if you're operating in fear and they're fearless, then they're going to be the ones to kind of get that opportunity. So for me, I'm like, I'm the girl.
Mm-hmm.
Let me throw 1,000 opportunities out there.
That's
even
great.
If I only get one yes back,
sure.
I tried.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
I don't care.
That's awesome. That is so great, because a lot of people have that. The fear overtakes,
yeah.
You know, and you're paralyzed.
Yeah.
So I'm proud of you. That's great. That's hard to get to that point.
It is.
So good for you to do that. That's fantastic. So with that being said, what kind of challenges, or I guess, how do you push through challenges or daily roadblocks that you may have? I guess, what gets you through those?
I have a very, very close circle. So I always tell people, like, don't tell everybody your dreams and,
mm-hmm.
and your hopes, but you should always have that maybe 2 or 3 people that you can pick up the phone and be honest with and say, I'm not doing so good today.
Mm-hmm.
Or like I said before, why, what did I do?
Yeah, right.
So when I feel like that, I mean, I'm also, you know, I'm a Christian. I do go and I read my devotionals and I read my Bible, but sometimes I need that other human interaction to say, you're human. You can feel like this, but you're also awesome.
Yeah.
Keep going.
That's awesome.
So it's my close circle of family and friends that I can always call and just be honest that, like, you see all this amazing stuff on social media, but Leah's not doing so good.
Yeah.
And then lastly, I have a lot of entrepreneurial books, and I'm going to plug this one because it is amazing.
Mm, great.
Damon John has his new book that's out, and it'll come to me in a little bit, The Power of Broke.
Oh.
And he tells all these stories of these entrepreneurs he's met along the way,
wow.
Some on Shark Tank, some other places, but it's like they've been through it,
mm-hmm.
and they've come out on top. Maybe not financially, but they're at the top of their game. And sometimes I'll reference that book and I'm like, oh, that's where I'm at right now. They were there, but look at them now. Okay, girl.
That's great.
Go do it.
Yeah.
So that is my book.
Absolutely. So at least you have like a point A to point B. You can see someone who's gone through it.
Yeah.
And they've come out on top. You're like, well, if they can do it. And
they can just do it, I'll just keep going.
And they're an ordinary person, just like you and I and everybody else. So
exactly.
That's awesome. I love that. Everybody has to get out that book. I'll have to get it myself.
It's amazing.
Yeah. So I think you answered it. But I'm going to ask it anyway. If you could be or do anything in the world as a career, what would you be doing?
Exactly what I'm doing right now.
That's awesome.
I had a lady ask me that on the plane 2 weeks ago, and she's like, this is so weird. This just popped in my head, but I just have to ask you. And she asked me the same question. I'm like, exactly what I'm doing right now. It's crazy. A lot of people don't get it. My businesses, they all kind of talk to each other. So
they do.
Inspire
yeah,
style,
I can see that.
Open up the door for me to meet you or like the networking part of it to meet you at DFA through someone else that I knew because I wrote for DFW Style Daily. And then that opens the door to brand opportunities. Well, if I have a marketing client that needs an event, I've met this brand. So now that's a potential sponsorship or I'm interviewing a designer. Now I have a personal shopping client who's looking for that aesthetic. Oh, I interviewed them on Inspire and Style. So they all kind of talk to each other, it's great, and I wouldn't have it any other way.
I would want your life.
It sounds amazing. That's 20% where I'm like, really? Really?
I understand that.
You're like, for real?
Where's my role, God? What's going on here?
For real?
Yeah. So what would you want your legacy to be?
My legacy for when I have children someday, I want them to know that mommy was fearless and that every step of the way, even right now, I thought about them. It had nothing to do about finances. It's more of like, I set these things up because I want you guys, if you have an idea, I want you to know how to take it from start to finish, bring it to market, and be successful so that you can continue something and leave something behind for your kids.
That's great.
And let me make all the mistakes financially so that I can teach you how to have a wealth mindset and invest or buy this, you know, real estate or the things that I'm learning now. So when I think of legacy, it's more of that. Let me make all the mistakes. I want my kids to not be fearful of creativity.
Right.
Go for it. I don't want you to be fearless. Like, be like mom and just see whatever sticks at the wall.
Exactly.
And then for my own family, and not in the future sense, but as of right now, I want them, if they have something that they're so passionate about, don't get stuck in corporate or don't get stuck in what society has told us we're supposed to do.
Right.
I'll take all the hits. You know, I'm the one that went to law school and spent a ton of money on law school, but I want my immediate family to see, like, she's grinding. And when I do call them and tell them I'm not okay, but then the next day they see that, oh, well, you got nominated for this or got this award here, I want them to see that because I want them to be inspired to create some sort of legacy, whether it's business or writing a book. So we didn't just live life unintentionally on earth. We did it intentionally and we left something behind.
That's fantastic.
So
that's a beautiful legacy. I love that. And so, do you have a personal mission statement?
It changes all the time. Yeah. First, it was a real girl for real beauty.
Oh.
And because I was never the fashionable, I mean, people think I'm fashionable, but I see other people. So, like, Tendai, who owns this showroom, like, I'm like, I could never do that. I mean, she walks out, I'm like, go, girl. I never thought about that as myself. I've just always just been real. Mm-hmm. So whether it's in business or whether it's in fashion, I'm just real. If somebody, oh, what are you wearing today on the carpet? Target.
And that's what people want to hear, you know? And the way that you put it together, you're like, okay, you're actually really talented. I mean, not everyone can do that.
Target.
Yeah.
But recently, I still stick to that, but recently my thing is like, you know, in a world full of dust and just ordinary, just be a unicorn.
Yeah.
So I am a unicorn now.
That's awesome.
I stick out and I love it.
I love that. I love that.
So just be you. Be different, be unique, and be authentic to yourself.
I love that. Yeah. That's perfect. Okay, so we're going to do some personal questions here. No fun, I promise. Do you have a favorite restaurant anywhere in the world?
I do. My fat kid side is about to come out. I love Crustacean in Beverly Hills.
Oh.
I don't know. I forget the family that owns it. I think it's the Ann family. And they have the most amazing garlic noodles.
Oh, my gosh.
And they're so known good. For the garlic noodles, girl.
Really?
Yes. I get the crab out of the shell because I'm lazy. If I'm coming to the station, I'm hungry.
I don't want
to
work for my food.
I don't want to work for my food. I want to pull the top of the crab off and it's there.
Right.
So my friend that always goes with, she gets the crab and she cracks. And I'm like, oh, I'm fine. Yeah. I don't have to work for my food. It's amazing.
Oh, so wow. Crustacean. Okay. Everyone got to check out the Crustacean in Beverly Hills.
Yeah. And locally, shameless plug. The Island Spot.
Oh, great.
Meat just falls off the bone, just seasoned to perfection, and then I just drink rum cocktails all day long. True story.
Oh, my God, we may have to go there after this.
No. Yes. Will.
Do you have a favorite place to shop anywhere?
Gosh, these are hard questions. I have so many favorites. Here in town, down at Bishop Arts, Indigo 1745. Has become my absolute favorite. I mean, I was like everybody else, like, oh, I love Nordstrom, I love Belk. But it's more of like the smaller mom and pop. I know there's only three of those.
Yes.
So to go in there and be able to find Texas-based beauty products or hand lotions or Texas-made teas, and they're just soft as butter.
Oh, yeah.
I'm in there all the time. They just, here, just have my paycheck. My check.
I love that.
So that's one of my favorite, absolute favorite. And then you leave and you go to Emporium Pies and get a piece of pie.
So good.
What more motivation?
Yeah. That is a perfect shopping day right there.
You shop, then go get pie.
Go get some pie. Yes. I love that. Shopping pie. Sense. Yeah, it does. Totally. who wouldn't want that?
Do it after, though. If you do it before you start pooping out, true. Like, why won't this fit? Well, it's because you ate the pie before.
Yeah.
You go after.
Yeah, good. Oh, very good advice. Yes. I like that. So what's the one thing that people don't know about you?
The one thing that people don't know about me?
Or that you don't think that they are something that's unique?
I think people, because they watch how I do things or how I put stuff out on social media or like doing things like this with you today, they're like, oh, she's so cool. I'm not that cool.
I think you're pretty dang cool.
My baby sister will tell everybody, like, she's not cool. She doesn't think I'm cool. It's offended me.
Your sister.
Well, Ashley is 14 years younger.
Okay.
She doesn't think I'm cool. I'm the biggest nerd, so people will tell you that I love to read. My happy space is Half Price Books.
Oh, that's great.
Not only am I getting it for a good price, but it's like a world of just like goodness. And I go straight to the fashion and beauty section. I probably have every fashion designer's autobiography, and I get all cozy in my pajamas, and I make my chamomile tea, and then I put my feet up and I read. And I love that. I love to read that and marketing reports. It's very weird.
You gotta get balance,
though. All the entrepreneur
books.
Yeah. I mean, I read. I'm the biggest nerd, and I don't think they think I do fashion stuff all day, and that's not true. I have books. Actually, I probably have like 100 that I've bought from Half Price.
Oh, wow.
That I can't get to. They just look nice in my office.
Well, and people who come in there be like, oh my God, you're an avid reader. That's impressive.
Yeah, and it's like, I haven't touched those yet. And
well,
it's
you don't have
sad.
To tell.
It's so sad.
You're kind of busy. I mean, I just listed off all the things you do, so you're a little busy, girl.
But I keep going to Half Price and buying five or six at a time. Like, what are you doing? You're not.
It's like me and shoes.
Is that a hoarding problem?
I don't know. Maybe that's the next segment.
I know.
No, but I love that. I mean, if you know, for reading, especially entrepreneurial books and, of course, fashion books, you got to keep up to date.
Yeah.
But that kind of, I mean, that's what gets you inspired, you know? Other people's stories, like you were just talking about Damon John's book, and I'm the same way. That helps me so much.
Good, I'm normal. But
yeah,
still
no,
unicorn.
Yeah, you're a unicorn for sure.
I'm kind of.
Oh
normal.
Yeah,
for good.
Sure. So, is there anything else that you would like to add to this fabulous conversation that I want to have like all day long because it's so much fun?
Oh no, you're just amazing,
oh,
and you're so
thank
fabulous,
you.
And this
thank
is
you.
Amazing.
Oh,
yeah. I want this afterwards.
You can borrow it.
Awesome.
Thank
and
you.
Her shoes, she just showed me.
Oh yes.
I think I always just want to leave people with just don't be afraid to go for it. My business coach always tells me to start before I'm ready. I'm a perfectionist.
I like that.
It is a disease. It's a horrible, horrible disease because it will stop you from doing what it is you know you're supposed to be doing.
Mm-hmm.
So recently I just kind of put out to a couple local businesses, hey, I love social media. I love photography from my phone. I love taking things and putting this artistic view on it. I love researching hashtags. Here's the nerd.
That's awesome. That's great.
So let me do it for you. And it kind of just snowballed into this craziness of everybody kind of reaching out to me, wanting to do social media. And then my contacts within the business, I just added on a PR label. Like, these are my friends anyways. I'm
sure.
With you guys 3-4 times
absolutely.
A week.
Absolutely, yeah.
So come check this out or come do this. And that kind of branched into a digital marketing agency where we do digital marketing, social media marketing, and PR services for small businesses and entrepreneurs. That was not
That's
in
great.
My plan at
wow.
all, at all. And it has just like,
that's fantastic.
And so for anybody out there, just know if you're taking those steps day by day to do what you're supposed to do,
mm-hmm.
things will just gravitate towards you. And keep an open mind. Like
yes.
I said, I didn't think I was going to be doing this, but it's just a segment of what I love. And so
that's great.
When people talk about those multiple streams of income, you just got to keep an open mind that it's going to come from places.
Yeah.
And it's going to come before you're ready. We're still working on the official website.
Okay.
And I'm still getting hit up for business.
That's
so,
fantastic. That's
right.
Not a bad problem to have. That's
so,
great. Good for you.
Get rid of that perfectionism.
Yeah,
disease.
It does. It does paralyze you. And it's like you said, I love that. Start before you think you're ready.
Mm-hmm.
I need to remember that more and more because that's a great thing to remember.
Yeah, just start.
Yeah, because you'll never start because you don't think you're ever ready. So
I'm never ready.
That's great.
Never.
Oh my God, you're fantastic, Leah. Thank,
thank
you so much for speaking with me today.
Thank you for having
Absolutely.
Me.
Absolutely. Thank you guys for watching. This is Their Story Told, and I appreciate everything that you come and watch us and meet Leah and come back and see us. Thanks so much. We'll see you next time. Bye.